Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh dan salam sejahtera. Okay, so we can continue our lesson on solution of equation. Okay, so objective. So in this lesson, you will know how to solve linear equation. So linear equation yang selalu korang buat tu, pindah, tambah, pindah sebelah jadi tolak, tolak, pindah sebelah jadi tambah dan seterusnya. And then understand how to use factorization. Saya type kita habis ni. And then completing the square and quadratic formula to solve quadratic equation. And last one, solve cubic equation using long division and synthetic division. Okay, so first we look on the solving linear equation. Okay, so example, solve this one, 3x minus 3 equal to negative 2 for x. Okay, so selesaikan persamaan ni untuk x. Okay, this one we call it as linear equation. X, the highest power of the variable is 1. Okay, so to solve this one, 3x minus 3 equal to negative 2. Okay, so which one we want to move first? So we have minus 3 and 3 times by x. Okay, so kita ada 2 ni. Okay, so mana satu nak pindah? Okay, kita tengok. Okay, so let's say you want to move this one, 3. 3 multiply by x. Oops, sorry. Tak boleh nak padam pula ni. Kita okay, tak apa ni. Okay, so 3x minus 3 equal to 2. Okay, so you want to move 3 first. 3 this one apply to only this x, dia bukan darabkan dengan negatif 3 sekali. Okay, so if you move this 3, so tengok yang tinggal bulatan ni adalah x sahaja. Okay, so x dalam bulatan minus 3 is equal to 2 divided by 3. So there is extra things here outside the circle. So we have negative 3 outside the circle. So in this form, you do it in the wrong way. Okay, so awak buat salah kat sini. Okay, sebab ada tertinggal ni, negative 3. Okay, so let's say you move negative 3 first. Okay, so this minus 3 is applied to all of this one, 3x minus by 3. Okay, so if you move negative 3, okay, so this one is circle, is equal to 2 plus by 3. Okay, so nampak kita ada bulatan. There is no extra thing outside the circle. So therefore this one correct. Okay, so next, teruskan. So dah sebab dia betul, kita teruskan, which is equal to 5. Then x is equal to 5 divided by 3. And this one, second, so find the value of x if 1 minus x equal to 0. Okay, so this one same thing as the first question. So we have here 1 minus 2x equal to 0. Okay, so 1 is equal to 2x, or 2x is equal to 1, and then x is equal to 1 over 2. Okay. So tapi nanti dalam exam dia tak ada lah keluar linear, yang linear ni. Nanti yang keluar yang cubic tu. Okay, so this one just recall back. Okay, revision. Okay, so solve quadratic equation. Okay, solve this quadratic equation by factorize completing square. And one more we have, okay, so one more we have this one, quadratic formula. Okay, so factorize. So factorize. Okay, so this one you factorize, so you will have x minus 6 and x plus 1 equal to 0. And then you take x minus 6 equal to 0 and you obtain x equal to 6, or x plus 1 equal to 0 and you will obtain x equal to negative 1. Okay, so ni biasa tekan calculator je. Okay, so this one completing the square, which is CTS. Okay, so last time I already teach you in equation of circle and parabola. Okay, okay, so in we have 2 bracket plus 1 bracket power of 2 and then minus back 1 bracket power of 2. So inside the bracket we put negative 5 divided by 2. Here also same, negative 5 divided by 2. And then here negative 5 divided by 2. So put here, and this one x, okay, inside the bracket and then power of 2. So minus negative 5 power of 2, which is 25, and 2 power of 2, which is 4. at minus 6 equal to 0. And then calculate this one. So you will obtain negative 49 over 4. And then solve for x. So you will have x minus 5 over 2 square is equal to 49 over 4. And then, okay, so square bring to the right. So you will have x minus 5 over 2 equal to square root of 49 over 4. So which is equal to, okay, so when square root, you will have positive negative 7 over 2. Okay, so square root 49 is 7 and square root 4 is 2. Okay, so the answer for x, so you will have x 5 over 2 is equal to, the first thing is positive 7 over 2, and second you will have is equal to negative 7 over 2. Okay, so next solve for x, so you will have 7 over 2 plus 5 over 2. Okay, so 7 plus by 5, which is 12. So 12 over 2, so this is 6. And here x is equal to negative 7 over 2 plus by 5 over 2. So negative 7 plus by 5, which is negative 2. So negative 2 divided by 2, so you will have x equal to negative 1. Okay. So jawaban ini sama, okay? So yang tadi kau factorize x equal to 6, x equal to negative 1. And then CTS also same, x equal to 6 and x equal to negative 1. Okay, so here so same quadratic formula. So just now the equation is x square minus 5x minus 6 is equal to 0. And then substitute into this formula, x is equal to negative b plus minus square root b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. So substitute b, b which is negative 5 and c is negative 6. Okay, so this one a, b, c. Okay? So a is 1, b negative 5, c is negative 6. Okay? Okay, so siapa yang tak faham lagi, okay, saya tulis dalam bentuk ni. So a is 1, b is negative 5, and c is negative 6. Okay? So substitute this one and you calculate, so you will have this one. So which is x is equal to 5 plus minus square root 49 over 2. Okay, so first you will have x equal to 5 plus square root 49 over 2, which is equal to 5 plus 7 over 2, which is equal to 6. And then second, so you will have x is equal to 5 minus square root of 49 divided by 2. So which is equal to 5 minus by 7 divided by 2. Okay, so which is equal to negative 1. Okay, so jawapannya sama dengan yang atas tadi, 6 dan negative 1. Okay, so this one the main things, okay. Okay, so solving the cubic equation. So dalam topik ni, so inilah dia punya main benda yang kita nak paling utama yang kita nak belajar. Okay, so solving cubic equation. Okay, so concept division in number. Okay, so first we look on the concept of division of number. So for example, 45 divided by 4. Okay, so 45 divided by 4. Okay, as usual you do here multiply by 1, here 4, so minus becomes 0, and then bring down number 5, and then 4 times what, which is near to 5, so times by 1, so which is 4, and we have 1. Okay, so this one we call it as divisor, pembahagi. Okay, and this one we call it as remainder, baki. And this one we call it quotient. Okay, so hasil bahagi, okay. So quotient, which is hasil bahagi. Okay, so therefore then, okay, so therefore this 45, okay, so 45 you can write down as 4, which is divisor, times with the quotient 11 plus by remainder, okay. So 45 is equal to 4 times 11 plus 1. Okay, so this one divisor, quotient and remainder. selesai aja nih, sebab konsep in forming the the division of the cubic function. Okay, so nanti dalam cubic function ni, solving cubic function, so you will have step on what we call it, long division. Okay, so long division ni kita buat macam ni juga, pembahagi ni. Okay, so the equation we can write down as this one, divisor times by equation at plus remainder ni kat bawah ni. Okay, so this one. Okay, so fx is equal to x is equal to divisor quotient plus remainder. Okay, so divisor times with quotient plus remainder. Okay, so this one fx divide by divisor. Okay, so bila fx ni kita bahagikan dengan dia punya pembahagi, so fx ni we can write down as divisor times by quotient plus by remainder. For example, this one. Okay, so fx divide by x minus 1. So later fx ni nanti adalah dia punya fungsi double cubic equation. Okay, so you will have quotient here, and then buat dekat bawah ni akan dapat remainder. Okay, so therefore fx can be written as divisor. Okay, so x minus 1, and then this one is the quotient. Okay, and minus by remainder. Ni contoh eh, ni contoh. Okay, so before we go to the long division, okay, so we look on, we going through to the remainder theorem. Okay, so remainder theorem said that if a polynomial fx is divided by x minus c, then the remainder is fc. Okay, so contoh ni, given fx equal to 2x power of 3 minus x square minus 18x plus 9, find the remainder when fx is divided by x minus 2. Okay, so konsep batas tu tadi kita, saya bagi tahu apa, bila kita bahagikan fx dengan pembahagi dia divisor, this one, when fx divided by divisor, so we can write down as this one. Okay, so kita boleh tulis dalam atas, bentuk atas ni. So fx is equal to divisor, so in this case the divisor is x minus c times with the quotient x plus by remainder x. Okay, okay, so then to find the remainder, kita nak cari remainder kat belakang ni. Okay, in the short calculation. Okay, so dalam jalan kerja yang pendek, kita tak payah nak buat long division ni. So we can simply substitute x with c. So x minus c, substitute x with c. So which is equal to c minus c, and then q of c plus r c. Okay, so this one c minus c is 0, right? So this one become 0. Okay, so 0 times q c become 0. Therefore f c is equal to remainder. Okay. Okay, so untuk cari remainder, kita simply put fc. Contoh this one, given fx equal to x power of 3 minus x square minus 18x plus 9. So find the remainder when fx is divided by x minus 2. So kita nak cari remainder. Okay, so takkan kita nak buat long division. Kalau kita nak buat long division, jalan kerja dia panjang. Okay, so long division. Okay, so divide by x minus 2. So you put 1, and then that, and then that, and then continue here. Kan panjang kan? Okay, so therefore this theorem, okay, it help you to find the remainder in short way. Okay, so then to find the remainder, so just put f here minus 2. So we take here 2. So it is equal to 2 times 2 power of 3. Minus by 2 power of 2. Okay, so tak muat, saya tulis bawah. Minus 18 times with 2 plus by 9. So you will have here 2 times with 8 minus by 4 minus 36 plus by 9. Okay, so this one 16 minus 4 minus 36 plus 9. Okay, so the answer is berapa ni? Okay, so the answer is negative 15. So kalau nak pakai long division ni, panjang lah. Tapi kalau soalan suruh guna long division, terpaksa lah. Okay, so long division saya tak ajar lagi. Okay, nanti saya ajar. Okay, so this one, factor theorem. Okay, so second factor theorem. So this factor theorem said that x minus c is a factor or root of fx if and only if fc equal to 0, which is the remainder is equal to 0. Okay, so ni akan jadi factor. Contoh yang atas ni tadi. So from the factor, if the remainder is 0. But here remainder is not 0. So for example this one, determine whether x minus 2 is a factor of fx equal to this one. Okay, so to show, to check whether this one is the factor, so we use f, this one f2. Okay, so kita masukkan 2 dalam ni f2, and then we look on the remainder. Okay, so kalau kita nak buat long division nanti panjang. Okay, okay, so then we calculate f2. So f2, so because here negative 2, so we calculate f2, so equal to 2 times with 2 power of 3 minus by 2 power of 2 minus by 7 times by 2 and then plus by 2. So this one, 2 power of 3, 8 times by 2, 16 minus by 2 power of 2 is 4 and then minus 7 times by 2 is 14 and plus 2. So the answer is this one, 12 minus 14 plus 2 negative 2 plus 2. Okay, so the answer 0. Okay, so this one 0, f2 is equal to 0. Okay, so this one is the remainder lah, sebab daripada factor theorem f2. Okay, so this one is remainder. Okay, so when this fx divided by x minus 2, therefore the f2 is the remainder. And since for the from the factor theorem, if the remainder is 0, therefore we can say that x minus 2 is the factor of fx. Therefore x minus 2 is factor for fx. Okay, so next, okay, so ni kita masuk dalam. Okay, so long division, by using long division find the quotient and remainder when fx, this one is divided by x minus 1. Okay, so kita buat lah. So 3x power of 3 minus x square plus by 5x minus by 6 divide by x minus by 1. Okay, so how to do? So here we look here, 3x cube, here is x. Kita tengok x ni, nombor ni jangan tengok dulu. Okay, so we look on x and 3x cube. So x times what will be equal to 3x cube. So x times with 3x power of 2. Betul tak? So 3x kuasa 2 darab dengan x, so you'll have 3x power of 3. Okay, so kita nak ni. Okay, so therefore you expand this one, x times with this one. Okay, so already calculate, become 3x power of 3 and then negative 1 times with 3x square, so become negative 3x square and then minus. So 3x cube minus 3x cube, 0. Negative x square minus by negative 3x square become positive 2x square. Okay, and then bring down this one, positive 5x. And ini nak bawa turun ke? Boleh, nak bawa turun pun boleh. Minus by 6. And then, again, look on x and here 2x square. So x times by what will be equal to 2x square. Okay, so you times with positive 2x. Okay, so darabkan dengan positive 2x. Okay, so 2x times with x, positive 2x times with x, so you will have 2x power of 2. And then positive 2x times with negative 1, you will have negative 2x. And then minus. So 2x square minus 2x square, 0. And 5x minus by negative 2x become positive 7x minus by 6. Okay, so bawa turun yang ni. And then again, you look on x and 7x. So x times with what is equal to 7x. So x darabkan dengan apa dapat 7x. So x times y positive 7. Okay, so 7 times x you will have 7x, and negative 1 times with 7 you will have negative 7, and then minus, so you will have 7x minus 7x 0, negative 6 minus negative 7 become 1, positive 1. Okay, dah dapat. Okay, so this one become quotient, and this one become remainder. Saya tak faham lah macam dapat atas ni. Okay, so macam mana nak dapat ni? Ingat balik tadi macam mana 45 bahagi dengan 4. Macam mana korang dapat 4 darabkan dengan apa dapat 4 kan? So 4 darabkan dengan 1. Okay, so dapatlah 4, 0 minus. And then 4 times what? Okay, so this one bring down 5. Okay, so 4 darabkan dengan apa akan dapat dengan 5 ataupun hampir dengan 5. Okay, so 4 darabkan dengan 1 lah. So sini akan jadi 4. 4 darab 1, 4. So here 1. Dapat remainder dia. Okay, so in this case pun same lah, konsep dia sama dengan macam ni. Okay, so tapi kalau yang tak pernah belajar, tak tahu lah, saya rasa dulu pernah belajar kalau masa zaman sekolah menengah ke sekolah rendah rasanya belajar ni. Okay, so dalam case ni pun sama lah. So kita tengok x darabkan dengan apa, dia dapat 3x kuasa 3. Bawah ni pun sama, x times with what is equal to 2x power of 2. And then bila korang dah dapat, kita akan expandkan dia. Okay, so therefore for this one quotient is equal to 3x power of 2 plus 2x plus 7, and remainder is equal to 1, baki dia 1. Okay, so tak faham lagi. Okay, contoh lagi sekali. Example, by using long division, find the quotient and remainder of this one is divided by x plus 2. Okay, so tulis, so x power of 3 minus 2x square, and then minus 4. Okay, so kalau kita tengok kat sini, x kuasa 3, x kuasa 2, yang x tak ada kan, missing x. Okay, so for the x, you just put 0, 0x ni. So kalau ada term yang hilang tu, letak kosong x ni, and then minus by 4. Sebab sebab cubic equation ni biasa bentuk dia macam ni, ax power of 3 plus bx square plus cx plus d. So we have power of 2, power of 3, power of 2, power of 1, and constant. Okay, so kalau salah satu ni hilang, kita letak kosong je. Kosong, for example this one, 0x divided by x plus 2. Okay, so again, look on this one, x power of 3 and x. So x times with what is equal to x power of 3. Okay, so siapa yang tak boleh congak, tulis kat tepi ni. So x times with what is equal to x power of 3. And then you bring this one to the right. So become, so apa yang korang nak cari ni is equal to x power of 3 divided by x, which is x power of 2. Okay, so dapatlah sini x power of 2. Okay, so x times x power of 2 become x power of 3. Positive 2 times x power of 2 become positive 2 x power of 2. And then we do minus x power of 3 minus x power of 3, 0. Negative 2 x square minus positive 2 x square become negative 4 x square. And then bring down this one, plus 0 x minus by 4. And then again, so look on x and negative 4x square. So x times with what? Okay, so x times with what is equal to negative 4x square. So nak cari apa ni? So it is equal to negative 4x square divided by x. So you will have negative 4x. Okay, so put here negative 4x. And then expand, so x times negative 4x. So you will have negative 4x power of 2. And positive 2 times negative 4x become negative 8x. Okay. And then minus negative 4x square minus negative 4x square become 0. And then 0x minus negative 8x become positive 8x. And then minus by 4. Okay, so next. Again, so look on 8x and x. So x times with what? Okay, so x times with what will equal to 8x. Okay, so cari ini, yang tanda soal ini, 8x divided by x. So the answer is 8. Okay, so therefore this one positive 8 here. And then expand x times positive 8, so become positive 8x. And then positive 2 times positive 8 become positive 16. And then minus 8x minus by positive 8x, 0. Negative 4 minus by positive 16, negative 20. Therefore, we have the quotient, which is equal to x power of 2 minus 4x plus 8. And remainder is equal to 8x minus by 4. Another question. Okay, so this one, find all the roots of polynomial px equal to 6x cube and so on. So macam mana nak cari ni? Dia tak ada tulis pun boleh bahagi dengan apa. Okay, tadi saya pause video, gizma yang kejap ni, so sorry. Okay, so for this question, find all the roots of polynomial px of this one. Okay, so for this one, first you need to try and error lah. So try and error to detect the root of this polynomial. Okay, so dalam calculator tu senang je lah cari root kan. So untuk kuasa 3 dia boleh, untuk dalam calculator. Okay, so bila dah jumpa 1, so let's say you have 1. So for example, P negative 1. Okay, so calculator nanti dia akan terus bagi jawapan. So ambil 1, so let's say I choose negative 1. So put here and calculate. So 6 times negative 1 power of 3 plus 5 negative 1 power of 2 times negative 1 minus by 2. Okay, so this one equal to negative 1 power of 3, negative 1 times 6, negative 6. 5 times negative 1 power of 2, so plus 5. And then negative 3 times negative 1, positive 3, and minus by 2. So this one is equal to negative 1 plus 3 minus 2. So the answer is 0. Okay, so therefore negative 1, this one is the root of px. Okay, so since it is the root of px, so therefore first factor. Okay, so first factor for px is x plus 1. Okay, so factor yang pertama adalah x tambah 1. Okay, so this one root negative 1. So factor dia x plus 1. Okay, so next, since you already found the first factor, so you can proceed to do long division. So 6x cubed. Okay, so 6x cubed. Mana tadi soalan dia? Okay, so 6x cubed plus 5x square. And then minus 3x minus by 2 divide with x plus 1. Okay, so as usual, x times with what is equal to 6x power of 3. Okay, so tulis ini x times with what is equal to 6x power of 3. So this one is equal to 6x power of 3 divided by x, so which is equal to 6x square. Okay, so dalam exam ni tak payah tulis pun tak apalah. So just jalan kira kasar je. So we have here x times with 6x power of 2. So 6x power of 2. Okay, we have here. So next we expand x times 6x power of 2. So we have 6x power of 3 plus 1 times 6x power of 2 plus 6x power of 2. And then minus, so this one minus by this one, 0. And positive 5x square minus positive 6x square become negative x square. And then bring down this one, negative 3x and negative 2. And again, so x times with what is equal to negative x power of 2. So we times with negative x. So x times negative x become negative x power of 2. Positive 1 times negative x become negative x. Okay, and then minus negative x square minus negative x square become 0. And negative 3x minus negative x become negative 2x. And bring down this one, negative 2. So x, okay, so again here we look on negative 2x and x. So x times what is equal to negative 2x. So we times with negative 2. X times negative 2 become negative 2x. And positive 1 times negative 2 become negative 2. And then minus, so this one become 0. And this one negative 2 minus negative 2 become 0. Okay. So therefore, x, yes, I write down here, px is equal to x plus 1 times with 6x square. Okay, so 6x square minus by x minus by 2. And then factorize this one. This one already become quadratic. So quadratic now factorize. So we have x plus 1. And then we have here 3x and here 2x. Okay, so 3x times 2. No. Okay, so wait. Okay, so here is 2. And here is 1. So 2 times 2, x, 4x, 3x. Okay, so negative. Negative 4x plus. Okay, so korang guna calculator kan. Ha. So we have here x plus 1, 3x minus 2, and 2x plus by 1. Ha. Okay, so this is the answer. Dah siap. Okay. Okay, so finish for division. And then we move to synthetic division. So synthetic division concept dia macam tadi sama je. Kita ada divisor, quotient and remainder. Only the method we use table. Okay, so synthetic division we use table. Okay. Alright, so now. So here is x cube, x square, x and constant. X kuasa 3, x kuasa 2, x dan constant. And then here on the below here. Okay, so from x power of 2, x power of 3, we reduce become x power of 2. And here x power of 2 reduce become x. And here x we reduce become constant. Okay, so maksudnya kita salin yang atas ni, kita buang x power of 3 ni lah. Okay, so and last one is one, we write down as the remainder. Okay, so apa yang kita nak isi dalam ni? Okay, so this one inside here. So first thing here, first line, first row, this one here. We write down the coefficient of x power of 3, which is here 1. And then coefficient of x power of 2, which is negative 4. And then coefficient of x, which is positive 6. Okay. And then the constant is 5. Okay, next. Okay, so the question using this synthetic division to find the quotient remainder of this one is divided by x plus 2. Okay, so divided by x plus 2, so this one. Okay, so we write down x plus 2 equal to 0. Okay, so let. And we have x equal to negative 2. Okay, so this negative 2 we will put here. Okay, So this negative 2 put here. Okay. And then next, so yang bawah ni, okay, so 1, this one we bring down 1. Okay, so bawah turun 1. And then 1 times with negative 2, we have here negative 2. And then negative 4 plus with negative 2. Okay, so kita tambahkan. So this one we plus. Negative 4 plus by negative 2 become negative 6. And then this negative 6 multiply with negative 2. And we put here. Negative 6 times negative 2 become positive 12. And then plus. 6 plus 12 which is 18. And then again multiply. 18 multiply with negative 2 which is negative 36. Okay. And then this one 5 and negative 36 be plus. So 5 plus negative 36 we have negative 31. Okay, so therefore here the quotient. Okay, so quotient. So quotient is equal to x power of 1 ax power of 2. So 1 x power of 2. So ni yang bawah ni quotient ni. Okay, so this one quotient. Okay, sampai sini sahaja quotient. And this one is the remainder. Okay, so we have the quotient which is 1x power of 2 and then negative x, negative 6x, and then plus by positive 18. And the remainder which is equal to negative 31. So, ini mudah sikit lah. Cuma nak kena ingat lah kat mana nak kena letak. Okay, okay, so next. The expression fx equal to this one has a factor 3x minus 2. Okay, so you use synthetic division to find the value of k. Okay, so dia suruh guna synthetic division untuk cari k. Okay, so kalau kita guna factor theorem, sebenarnya lagi senang lah. Tapi soalan minta synthetic division. Okay, so if the factor theorem, kalau kita guna factor theorem, if this one is the factor, so the remainder is 0. So for example, let 3x minus 2 equal to 0. So we will have x equal to 2 over 3. Okay? So if using the factor theorem, ni factor theorem. Okay, so we use f 2 over 3 is equal to 0. And then substitute into x, this one. Then calculate k. Okay, so nanti saya tunjuk kat bawah ni. So ni saya ikut soalan lah. Because soalan ask to use synthetic division. Okay, so first write down coefficient of x power of 3, which is 3. And then coefficient of x power of 2, which is negative k. And then coefficient of x, which is negative 8. And the constant is 4. And then here, this one, put here, 2 over 3. Okay, so next, bring down 3, bawa turun 3. Then 3 times 2 over 3, which is 2. And then plus. Okay, so negative 3 plus, negative k plus 2 become negative k plus 2. And then negative k plus 2 times with 2 over 3. Nah, saya nak kira ni. So tak nampak tulis, okay. So negative k, saya tulis bawah ni. So negative k plus 2 times with 2 over 3. Okay, so this one 2 you will expand here. Okay, so negative 2k plus 4 and here over 3. Okay, so 3 ni tak payahlah nak expand. Kita terus saya tulis bawah semua sekali. All of this one, all of this one divide by 3. So you will have here negative 2k plus 4 divided by 3. And then this one we plus add. Okay, so susah nak kira rasa. Ha, tulis. So negative 8 plus negative 2k plus 4 divided by 3. Okay, so this 1 over 3, but here is negative over 1. Make it same the denominator. So negative 8 times 3, negative 24 over 3 plus by negative 2k plus 4 divided by 3. Okay, so this one you will have negative 24 plus negative 2k. Okay, so plus and negative, so become negative minus 2k, and then plus with plus, plus 4 divided by 3. Okay, so negative 24 plus 4, which is negative 20. So you will have here negative 20 minus 2k over 3. Okay, yang hilang lah, yang ni. Okay, so this one is just now is negative 2k plus 4 over 3. Okay, so you add this one become negative 20. Negative 20 minus 2k over 3. And then this one times with 2 over 3. Okay, so darabkan dia. Okay, so negative 20. So negative 20 minus 2k divided by 3 times with 2 over 3. So 2 times with negative 20, so negative 40. 2 times negative 2k, negative 4k. And then 3 times by 3, which is 9. Okay. So put here, negative 40 minus 4k divided by 9. Okay, so this one you add. Okay, so tambahkan. So you will have 4. Kejap. So here, negative 40 minus 4k over 9. So add this one, this two. So you will have 4 plus by negative 40 minus 4k over 9. This 1 over 1. And then times with 9, he also times with 9. So 4 times 9 is 36. And then positive here. Positive times negative become negative 40. And positive times negative 4k become negative 4k over 9. Okay, 36 minus 40, negative 4. Minus 4k over 9. Okay, so next. Okay, so since this one 3x minus 2 is a factor. Okay, so ni tadi tambahkan. So plus, saya lupa nak tulis. So plus this one become negative 4 minus 4k over 9. Okay. Okay, so since this one is the factor of this one, therefore the remainder must be equal to 0. Okay, so ingat tadi dalam factor theorem dia kata kalau benda tu adalah factor, remainder dia mesti kosong. Okay, so therefore we take this one the remainder. Okay, so negative 4 minus 4k over 9, negative 4 minus 4k equal to over 9. This one is equal to 0. And then solve for k. Selesaikan untuk k. So negative 4 minus 4k is equal to 9 times 0, 0. And then this one bring to the left. To the right. Kalau tak pun inilah. So negative 4 bring to the right. So negative 4k is equal to 4. So k is equal to 4 divided by negative 4, which is negative 1. Okay. Dah siap. Okay, so soalan suruh cari nilai k je kan? So k is equal to negative 1. Habis dah. Okay, so sebelum tu saya nak tunjukkan factor theorem tadi. Okay, saya delete ni. Yang ni pun saya delete. Okay, so factor theorem tadi. So from the factor theorem, this one is the factor of fx. So we have fc equal to 0, where c is equal to 2 over k. Okay, so kita masukkan. So 3 times with 2 over 3 power of 3 minus by k times with 2 over 3 power of 2 minus by 8 times 2 over 3 plus by 4 is equal to 0. Then calculate, so 3 Okay, so 2 power of 3 is 8. 3 power of 3 is 27. Minus k, 2 power of 2 is 4. 3 power of 2 is 9. And then minus by 8 times by 2, which is 16 over 3. Plus by 4 is equal to 0. Okay, so this one negative k times 4. Negative 4 over 9. Saya terletak kat depan lah. Okay, so this one 3 times 8. Okay, so this one actually we can cancel 3 and here become 9. So become 8 over 9. So this one here positive. Okay, so depan here positive. So here positive 8 over 9. And then minus 16 over 3 plus by 4, which is equal to 0. Okay, so calculate this one. Okay, so calculate become, so here negative 4k over 9 minus by 4 over 9 is equal to 0. Okay, so dia akan dapat macam yang ni tadi lah. So you can combine this one, which is negative 4k minus 4 divided by 9 is equal to 0. And then, okay, so 9 times with 0 become 0. So you will have negative 4k minus 4 equal to 0. So negative 4k is equal to 4, and then k is equal to 4 divided by negative 4, which is equal to negative 1. Pun sama jawapan dia. Cuma ni lagi pendek lah daripada nak buat synthetic division tu. Tapi but the question ask to use synthetic division, so tak boleh lari lah. Kalau dia tak suruh pakai synthetic division tu, so korang boleh guna factor theorem. Okay, so that's all for our video. See you later. Thank you and Assalamualaikum.